Hi everybody, welcome to Marade Mondays. Thank you so much for coming in. So great to see you here, everyone, and comments going already. That's brilliant. How's everyone doing? Are you doing as well as can be expected? Hopefully you're doing all well at home and staying safe and well. I am absolutely delighted and thrilled later on in about 20 minutes or so to welcome my very special guest, Fionnuala Sherry, violinist of Secret Garden. You all know Secret Garden. You know You Raise Me Up. You know all of their big, big hits. And of course, they have a new album out, The Nocturne, the 25th anniversary collection. And of course, it's 25 years since they won the Eurovision with Nocturne. So it's the most beautiful, beautiful song. And we have a real treat towards the end of the program when Fionnuala and Rolf will be playing Nocturne from their own homes as part of the Eurovision series. So hope you're all great, guys. And now, I hope you can hear me okay. All good. So I think there was a request last week for at the very end of the show for the Bally Desmond polka. So I'm just going to kick off with that, and hopefully you guys are doing really well. Stick up the comments there, and it's 23 already. Wow. Very good. So I just want to thank, also I want to thank people who have bought from my website this week. Thank you so much, guys. And I'm going to be putting up your names shortly as well. And thank you very, very much for your support, marienesbittviolin.com and solstice.shop for my jewelry. But anyway, I want to start with the Bally Desmond polkas, and my parents are playing on this in the second polka. So I love this. For that request, guys. That was a request actually from last week, from the end of the show, and I'm sorry I couldn't squeeze it in last week, but cheers. I'm going to have a bit of water here. How's everyone doing? So I'm just going to have a look at some comments. I know you're all extremely excited for my guest. Not as excited as me. Well, you are as excited as me. I'm so excited that Fionnuala Sherry is coming on. And she is the most amazing violinist, amazing person. She's my best friend. I'm very, very excited. I'm going to take some water now. So I just want to thank people who have, I'm going to put down my fiddle, and I'm going to thank people who, I always do this, every week I thank people who order from my website and keep my tiny, teeny, teeny business going, and thank you so, so much. And these are the fiddle orders this week. Look down here, your names are there. And it's my mother's book, The Fiddle, Irish Fiddle Tutorial. And that has, it's included a 41 track CD on all the ornamentation, tunes, modes, O'Carolan section, slower section, rare tunes. It's absolutely incredible. It's on back order again. We had some in last week and they're all gone again. So thank you so much to those people here underneath, and they are doing some of them are doing their lessons with me too. And but thank you so much for getting the fiddle tutors. And here we have the names of other people who have ordered from my site, the Colstein, Matthias Albany violin. Here we are. A few of you have this already. So that is the most beautiful fiddle. And that is on mariednesbitt.com. And this is my bow, my custom bow. And there's a sale on, guys, still for spring. So, but I just want to thank the person below who ordered the bow this week, and custom rosin. You see your names there. There's my custom rosin with my logo, and the Bovita humidifier kit. This is actually brilliant, guys, especially, you know, those in dry areas. And if you're traveling, not now, you won't be traveling, but anyway, but when you do, and this is the Bovita starter kit, and it's on my website, and you actually get a free pouch with it, and you put it in this lovely kind of velvet pouch, and you put it under the neck of your violin, and it really helps with the humidity of the violin. So thanks so much, guys, for getting that. And then we have Devil's Bit Sessions DVD and the Hibernia CD. Your names are there. Thank you so much. There's the Devil's Bit DVD, which is now on back order. It's a beautiful behind the scenes of my family in Tipperary. And, you know, it's a lovely companion to the CD, Devil's Bit Sessions. And the local mountain is called the Devil's Bit, and it's really beautiful area. We you know, climb that as often as we can, the Devil's Bit, and that's why we called it the Devil's Bit Sessions. So, and then my Hibernia CD, thank you so much for ordering that too. And these were the orders for this week, guys, and I just want to thank you so much. Then we have just coming down the exclusive Nesbitt Family Collection. That includes all the CDs and the DVD and my mother's tutorial. So thank you so much to the names below. I think it's Kathy Turberville and Jeffrey Vines. And then the Nesbitt Family Collection, Richard Goodman. Thank you so much, Richard. And then, of course, guys, as you know, I do lessons from my website. So it is hard to kind of get a place, but please book, because it would be really great to meet you online and see what you're up to with your technique and with your style, especially classical players who are very interested in the Irish style. And I'm, you know, more than happy to say hi. And it's great. It's great fun. It's online. And actually, it records your lesson and keeps it there for 30 days. And you can download your lesson. So it's a lesson recap as well. So those are my students for this week. And so thank you so much, guys. And so I am very, very excited. And I'll just have a look here. I'm just looking at the time. I'm going to carry on and play something, if you don't mind, before I bring my very, very special guest in. And I'm going to use my custom bow for this. This bow comes, the guys tend to get it with the black braided carbon and black hair, which is really funky. It's really, really cool. And I absolutely love it. And I'm going to give a tune on the viola now. Okay. And this tune is very apt for today. It's called Manona Héireann, Women of Ireland. And because Fionnuala is here today as well, there's two of us, two women. So I'm just gonna give it a go on the viola. And actually it's such a beautiful tune. I played this in Celtic Woman, of course, as well, but it's a lovely, lovely tune. I'll give it a go. Hope you like it, guys, and let's see what the comments are, because it's 42, so we better catch up. Hello. Oh, I'm driving a truck, can't really watch. Oh, no, my God, don't. But yes, fantastic. Maybe a little bit of Smash the Windows. Oh, fantastic. Why a different name on Raining Up? Oh, well, Raining Up was my brother's idea. Raining Up is a beautiful tune. I'm going to play a little bit of it for you. It was composed by my brother, Carl. And it was composed for my first album. And it goes... It's such a beautiful tune. So where he got that name was on the cliffs of Moher. When you look out over the cliffs of Moher in Ireland, you see the droplets coming up from the ocean instead of going down. Like you see the almost like, I suppose, you know, just going upwards. And it's such a beautiful sight. And that's where he got the name. So maybe a bit of Smash the Windows. Smash the Windows. Wow. That's a... Yeah, I love that tune. I tend to just play that tune with my mother. So it's, and when I get her on again, we'll play that. And let's see. Hey from Ireland, Craig Malloy. You're cooking. That's fantastic. Oh, Craig Malloy from Kilkenny, Ireland. Hi, Craig. Hi from Argentina. Guru's beautiful name. Michael Brown. I was never a fan of Mondays until this. That's great. Thanks, Michael. Kilkenny is one of my favorite places that I visit. It is absolutely beautiful. Hello from Australia, from Alicia Rose. Hello, pretty lady, from Marshall Coleman. Thank you very much. Seema, hello, fairy. Hi, Seema. Thank you for checking in again. Thanks for tuning in. Frida. Hi, Frida. So nice to see you. Frida is from Norway. So you're going to be very, very excited today with our guest, Fionnuala Sherry, and the performance later on from Fionnuala and Ralph. It's just amazing. So Shilji, hi, Mairead. Fantastic. I'm going down through these lovely, lovely Tom Fox. Hi, Mairead. Thank you. Lisa Bybee. Hi. Hi, Lisa. Lisa is one of my students and she's really good. She learns really fast. Oh my gosh, it's great to see you here. Hi from Brazil. I'm scanning down through these. Karsten, lovely to see you. Hi from Kansas. Los Angeles. Tom Kay from Manchester. Loving my Devil's Bit set. Very good. Thank you so much, Tom Kay. Hello from Korea. Thank you so much. Well, you must be very excited because, you know, Fionnuala is coming on soon. So I'm going to play a little bit. I'm scanning down through the comments so you can see all your comments. Hi from Japan, Gregory. Love your music. Thank you. And it's just, I just can't wait to talk to my friend Fionnuala. So I am going to go back here and I'm going to play a little bit just a little bit on the viola, because a lot of people love the viola and they love the sound of it. So I'm going to play a little bit of Manona Héireann because I know that I can see Fionnuala in the waiting room. So that is fantastic. Okay, so here we go. On the viola.
Manon Hearn's beautiful tune. Women of Ireland.
Women of Ireland. Manon Hearn there, guys, for you on the viola. And I'm going to just I really want to thank, first of all, my next guest for coming on because she's just incredible. She's my best friend, and she oh, she's just one in a million. And I want to just put on a few photos here first. Let's see, can I do this? So, because we have a few photos here, and I'm going to just put that up here and do these photos for you because these are beautiful and they're for the week that's in it for Eurovision and everything. These are beautiful photos for of Fionnuala and Rod winning the Eurovision and also since then as well. There's just such, you know, as you can see, she's so beautiful. And that was the night and the point. And I just wanted to introduce Fionnuala Sherry now after this and just say, look what an honor it is for her to come on here. And what a fiddle player she is, what a violinist. Absolutely amazing. And let's see here. Bring her back here and bring her back. Hi, Fionnuala.
Hello.
Hi. Oh,
Hi.
those glasses are really funky. I love them.
Yeah, I you know, you try to hide the age thing and sort of take the glasses off.
I love them. They suit my shirt and my bow.
The joys that after 25 years, yeah, I need glasses to read.
Fionnuala, I can't thank you enough for coming on here because you're such an iconic person, really. Everybody loves you. Everybody loves Secret Garden. But for me, you're my best friend, also, as well as being the most amazing musician. And you're also the most inspiring person I have ever met.
Stop.
Yes. So I'll stop embarrassing you. And
You are embarrassing me, right? Because I'm just sitting here and I'm listening to you play the viola and play Manon Hearn, and it's just incredible. And then playing the other tunes and Raining Up, and you just pop it out of your head. You have so many tunes. I'm in awe, really. Like,
Oh.
yeah, and I think all the good folk in Boston and everywhere should be hiring you straight away to do your own TV show. You're kind of wasted on Facebook.
Oh, well, look, listen.
Talent emerging here.
Come here, the week that's in it. Isn't it amazing? I know that Eurovision isn't happening this year, but they have the most amazing series on YouTube. And of course, you guys graced the last episode seven
Yeah.
on YouTube. And it's 25 years. Do you remember that night? I remember clearly myself.
Yeah, and you know, it is kind of funny because to see sort of the split difference of 25 years ago and to be where we are now, it's like it does feel like it's been a whirlwind. And that night was amazing because, you know, I don't know whether all your fans out there know that you and I were in the orchestra together and we were inseparable. You know, as everybody used to say back then, if you found one, you found the other. So, and I had just stepped out and left only a few months before that. So my first time back in Dublin.
Yes.
After recording our album with Rolf was to perform in the Eurovision. And, you know, on the stage that night and to feel the orchestra, knowing you were there, all my friends were there supporting me. I mean, what a privilege and what a blessing. Like, it's still to this day, you know, I'll never forget that. It was just one of those that you just, you know, was feeling like riding on the wave and being in the right place at the right time. And, you know, and it's, I do think it's still funny that this instrumental song won.
I know, this is the thing. I mean, like for me, I just, it was such, apart from the fact that you were in it, and it was so special for Ireland as well, because it was almost like Ireland won the Eurovision again, because we were always winning it. Do you remember?
Yeah. And six times up to then, I think, or seven. Yeah, something crazy. Yeah.
And then Fionnuala gets up on stage with Rolf in Secret Garden and wins it again for Norway. That's and everybody was celebrating, because Ireland was celebrating. The whole world were celebrating, and I was in the orchestra, and it was just incredible. Yeah. And you know, the fact that it had such a big part of it was the instrumental part was a very. Yeah. Like it was groundbreaking in a way, wasn't it?
It was, and actually nothing has been done since. And of course it did cause a lot of controversy afterwards, and with the normal rivalry between countries. And I mean, a few people said, is it really a song? You know, because there were 24 words at the beginning and the end. But it did qualify as a song. There's been nothing like it since. But, you know, maybe for us that was the good thing too, that it was so different. We actually felt going in when we were representing Norway that we were either going to lose and get 0 points because it would be too shocking, or some kind of momentum would build and we would gain a lot of traction. And we had just finished our first album, so we were using the Eurovision stage in a way to launch our first album, which I don't think really artists have done that either. And so it was, you know, a very good launch, and we were lucky the gamble paid off. And certainly Eurovision, you know, as you know, Mairead, I mean, then it was a whirlwind for years after that of touring. And, you know, for us, Nocturne and Eurovision, what it did in opening so many doors and letting us literally travel all over the world has been incredible. And, you know, we are blessed that it happened. And the double loveliness of it was that it was held in Dublin in Ireland that year. So it was a real home for home, you know.
It was, oh my gosh, it was, oh, incredible. It was an incredible, I remember every single second. I remember us picking your outfit. That beautiful corset. Oh my God. It was beautiful white shirt. And
I don't know whether you can remember. I didn't have time to shop for an outfit. Actually, the truth was that the Norwegian TV company, they had created a costume for me, and it was so not what I would like to wear. It was a dress and it was very stiff, and I didn't feel comfortable. And so everything I wore on that stage that night was really clothes that I had.
I mean, look at that. Look at you. Isn't it an amazing photo?
Well, and I was very heavily criticized for that costume as well. It is really funny, you know, that people didn't like the leather trousers, particularly in Norway, they didn't like it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I love them. They were like really
have them, which is great. I've never thrown that outfit out. Like, I do throw out a lot of things, but I've never thrown that out.
No, you couldn't. Yeah. and Fionnuala is incredible. She'll, I mean, they're all the comments are coming up, obviously, Fionnuala, you know, but it's such a fantastic, you know, it's a weird time. It's a weird time at the moment. Very, very weird. You, and I said earlier on, you're the strongest, most resilient, inspiring person I know. You've been through so much. I know it's been a lot of it has been covered in the media, because you're so well known. But you know, you've been through so much, and you at least, you know, even though this time is hard, you know, it's great to have the Eurovision home concerts, but also your new CD, my God, Nocturne, the 25th anniversary collection. What a beautiful, beautiful collection.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a very emotional collection for us. And actually, really, in a way, it's the people's vote for one. You know, because in, you know, Pandora in the States, when people are streaming on Pandora and Spotify, or over here, I mean, Universal, our record company, kind of looked to see what people were really listening to. And it was really, we took out the songs that have been hit a heart with people, and so that's really how the compilation came together. And you know, I'm just very grateful that it's kind of funny that we're in lockdown, but at the same time, with the power of technology that's out there, Rob and I were able to do promo, we were able to do videos, we were able to work on the covers, CD design, all of that remotely between conference calls between the States and London and Norway and here in Ireland. So it's kind of been, even though it's a very hard time, it's been a bit fascinating.
Yeah.
I'm not like you, Mairead, you're so amazing with everything that comes to technology. And
no, I'm not. My husband laughed at you, Fionnuala, for saying that.
Thank you. And you know, I am the dinosaur, so seriously, I am. As people know, I might appear on Facebook for a week and then you mightn't see me again for another month. So
that's just so busy. So anyway.
I think that this could happen during this time. It's our first worldwide instant release done digitally. You know, I'm a little bit sad that there isn't physical copies, because I like physical copies.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I like to hold it. But normally our albums, when we release them, it might be territory by territory. Oh. But this was like, press the button and out it goes. You know, it's kind of exciting. You know, our last album we had just done 2 years ago, Storyteller, I think was our last album to have some physical. And, you know, it was kind of done in that way, because of physical, they have to stagger the different countries because of copyright laws. So,
oh, I see. Yeah,
this went out straight out to everywhere.
That's good. In one way,
I'm just praying that people like it, and grateful for the lovely comments. And you know,
yeah, the comments are amazing.
Your support has been amazing. You know,
and Kathleen Nesbitt, my mother. I just want to show you that comment up there. Big hello to dear Fionnuala. Great to see her on the show. Looking beautiful as you both do. Hi from Knockmore.
Oh, your mama, she knows. Yeah, God, it is fun.
and I just want to show people the cover of this, of the beautiful cover. It's so beautiful, the Secret Garden cover.
We went to that kind of old, I mean, Rolf and I love that sort of old, timeless, and it's kind of the feeling of an old leather book, and that, you know, when you open it, you know, you just find, you know, something inside. So that was the kind of look we had, even though we're going for a digital kind of copy, but we wanted to give it some sort of sense of timelessness and an old flavor, you know. So yeah,
it's stunning. It's absolutely stunning. And you know, I think, what is your you know, the music business is such a hard business, isn't it? You know, it's such a, it, you know, we know all the hardships we've been through in the music business, but also from a personal point of view, you know, you've had you've had such battles to climb over. Like, you've had your breakages,
yeah,
in your wrist and your arm.
Scarred up.
And of course you have a battle now.
Yes,
you're fighting amazingly.
Yeah, well, yeah. So I'm just, for people that don't know, because I actually haven't really spoken about it that much, is that, yeah, I've had breast cancer for the past year. So, and I'm coming out at the end, and you can see I didn't lose my hair. I could do with some root touch up, but I've been very lucky because, you know, I had two lots of surgeries this time last year, and then a month of radiation, and then I have been doing infusions. And this week, which is also, May is sort of a funny, it's always a very good time for Rolf and I. So I finished my infusions this coming Thursday. So Yes, I am crawling though to the finish line. I have to say, without the support of you, Mairead, my family, friends, and it is, thank God, in one way that we've been able to do some of these, and I was able to do some of the home video recordings, because it's literally put on the makeup, do the recording, and then go to bed for another day or 2 days. That's the thing about this kind of, you know, a cancer treatment is you may look okay for a while and then you're gone. And I mean, to even do this chat this evening, I had to lie down this afternoon, which sounds crazy, but that's, you know, that's my reality at the moment. And at least it's getting better. And once Thursday is over, yay.
We're going to go online and glass of champagne together.
Oh my God, Mairead, the next time you're home and we'll go down to our favorite beach in Greystones. No, don't say that, because I'm going to get too emotional there.
But the thing is, what is your secret, Fionnuala? Is it from your dear parents or obviously your family? Like, you're so strong. You're so inspiring. You just go. You just keep going, you know?
See, well, I don't know. I came from a very disciplined background. Two parents as teachers, so we were never allowed to sort of mess up. And, you know, you were pushed to a certain extent, and I think that is good. And but I don't know. I think it's to do with being, you know, you and Ray don't know any different. I don't know any different. We need to play music. That kind of keeps us alive. And if we don't have music in our lives, it's like a flower wilting. It's not to do with ego. It's not to do with having to be, you know, for people to say to you that you're good or they like that or they don't. It's actually the physical necessity to play.
Yes,
and to feel that sound. And I've been told that I might know twice really, and now this breast cancer. The first time I broke my shoulder in many places, and I was told I might not play the violin again, so I had to climb through that one. And then 5 years ago I broke two arms. So and the thing is, if it's taken away from you, you even appreciate it more. And there was no choice. I don't think I'm very deep or philosophical in that I can say, oh, I learned a lot from that. I'm always amazed when people, you know, they have had illness and something happens and they talk about, you know, this amazing learning curve they've had. Either I'm very shallow or I don't know, but I just know that I can deal with a lot of pain. I can actually cope with
it. I know that for a fact. I've seen you dealing with a lot of pain.
Maybe that's just my way of dealing with it. I've just get on, take the pain, say, okay, this is what I have to do, and have a plan and know that, okay, you know, and it's a step-by-step kind of.
First of all, you look amazing and you sound amazing and you always sound amazing. And after the breakages, actually, you had to relearn how to play the violin. And I love the way you I remember saying it to you before, you know, the way you elongate phrases, you know, you drag out a note at the end of a phrase. So beautiful how you play. You really had to relearn a little bit how to obviously play.
So here's the thing. So just to my mom who died last year, but to just give you an idea of my parents and the sort of strength they had. So we had a 20th anniversary concert booked with symphony orchestra, cameras, everything, full TV production, which was due 3 months after I broke my arms. And so we had to postpone it, but we only postponed it to just 5.5 months. So I had plates put in and all of that, and when it came to coming up to the time of the concert, we discovered that the plates in my right hand, I had two plates put in, they were impinging on my bow arm, moving enough that I needed to get that finesse of a sound, you know, to be able to do a bow turn. So we opted to get the plates out, and that was tricky because I had to find a surgeon to do it. The original one didn't want to do it. It was too risky. So we did. But the awful thing was afterwards, a few days afterwards, I discovered it didn't really make any difference. I still had the problem. And I remember going into my mom, and this was like in June, and the concerts were in August. And saying to her, what am I going to do? And crying and like really feeling sorry for myself. And she just looked at me and she said, well, you just better figure out another way to play. And I was like, okay, right. Yeah, the audience had booked tickets, you know, everything was so. And I remember, and I was thinking about you, how you play, and you know, how all the amazing traditional players have that way of not being confined to the classical bow hold that I had. And I just thought, hang on, I have to find somewhere, there's somewhere in the middle here for me that I can. So that's literally what I did. I started just traveling up the bow until I could find a comfort spot so that I could maneuver it and work it. That my hand, because the danger was that my wrist could get locked, so I couldn't. So it's a bit like a golfer, say, teeing off from with a drive and saying they normally hit whatever 250 yards in the drive with their driver, but being told now you've got to try and get that distance, but to with a shorter club. And I had to figure out how to do that. And thankfully I did. And actually, for me now, some of the albums that I've done the last 2 years, particularly Storyteller, which we brought out just before I was diagnosed with breast cancer. So I actually had the tumor while I was recording that. And it's amazing. I didn't know. So
this comment, Fionnuala.
Yeah. So the thing is, that album means a lot to me as well, because, you know, because this was all this new technique being used in that, you know. So, but it just shows, it's like, it's, I always think, you know, if you're a musician and something happens, then you have to think of yourself as an athlete. And sports people, if they're used to getting injured and they don't take no, they go off, and there's nobody quicker that heals is any sports people. And in Ireland, where rugby is so big, I'm just looking at them like their crash case is coming up. And next thing you see them back 6, 8, 12 weeks, and phenomenal. So I kind of follow sports people. I'm very fascinated by their mental.
Yes.
Because they're so tough. But we're luckier than them, because we, you know, their careers end in, you know, very early. But, you know, you and I, well, we can go on a long time, you know, so we are really lucky. So,
yeah.
I have no choice, basically. Yeah. After all that, I have no choice.
Well, also, you know, you've got such a tightly knit family. I have a tightly knit family. And we have a great support system.
Yeah.
And also, you have your beautiful dog, Archie.
Yeah, I don't know where he is.
A lovely husband. Sure, Archie's gone. I had a lovely photo of Archie. I'm sure, I don't know where it is now. And
I know. Archie's been a huge support during all of this. But I'm just always have to have a dog. I always have to have animals around. And, you know, he's learned now that when we only rescued him a year ago, and the first few times he heard me play, well, I don't blame him. It was pretty choppy.
Oh.
Because I was not in great shape either. And he just disappeared. But now, as soon as the music comes on, he comes up and lies down. And same with my last dogs, you know. They generally... If you're playing scales, probably not. But, you know, once it starts really playing. So I think animals like music, you know, it's part of that.
Yeah, exactly. And I have some lovely photos here from the studio. Fionnuala, where is that?
That's, that's Camden Studio in
Dublin, is it?
Yes. Mm. And that's us actually recording Storyteller.
Wow. Amazing. So,
that's and of course, a half ago.
And this is a stunning. I look at this beautiful photo of you.
I have no idea where that is from.
Well, there you go. I have my sources.
Oh my God, yeah. And I love that picture that you found of the two of us that you posted on Facebook. I said, I must get that picture. My hair was so red. I just forgotten I had gone red for a while.
Listen, I have another one here. Look at this one.
Oh. Where's that from?
I think, you know what? It was Christmas time. It was on Grafton Street. I think we said, you know, I said we'll hop in here to Brown Thomas or somewhere. We went into Brown Thomas at a time when we could all go out, and we had our woolly hats on, and we went in. I'm sure we were browsing around the place, and it was beautiful.
Oh my God, I still look forward to those days again.
I know, I know. And I do have a little live clip of you playing, if I'm surprising Fionnuala with this now. You were playing this fiddle, this exact fiddle.
Oh yes, I
loved it, do you remember?
Yes.
That was a fiddle from my website, but the Mattias. But I have let's see will this play. Okay,
mine is here. Yeah,
do you remember? It's so beautiful. It was in the evening.
Great violin. Everybody should be wanting that violin. It's just lovely, isn't it?
You made it speak, hon.
It's a great instrument. It really is.
Oh, thank you. Oh,
that is funny seeing that.
Yeah, I got to your house and I said, you know, I have a few fiddles with me. You know, do you mind kind of. And I mean, the last thing probably that at night that you want to do
it was really curious. I'm so impressed with that range of fiddles. They're just fantastic.
Thank you.
Anybody that gets a hold of one is very lucky person. Yeah.
Oh, thank you, hon. I love Secret Garden. We've found them for years, Tim.
Yeah.
I mean, look, everybody is just, it's just bravo, maestro. And it's so beautiful. So, you know, fantastic Fionnuala violin. Yeah. So, I mean, you know, with the new album, it's, as you said, a very emotional collection. But so I don't want to keep you all night, Fionnuala, because I know Fionnuala has the dinner on. She's the dinner on. She's 5 hours ahead of me, and she's the dinner on in Ireland, and it's going to burn. So,
well, it is going to burn because my husband's probably forgotten it.
But it's impossible to touch off everything and everything and all the wonderful things that you have done, Fionnuala, and that you and Rolf have done. You Raised Me Up, for instance. Oh my God, how many versions is there of that in the world?
Yeah, we've lost count, actually. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That song, sometimes when we play You Raise Me Up, we feel like we're doing a cover version of our own song because so many people have had hits with it, which is wonderful. And it is, it's deeply, some of the really bad days when I've been, you know, pretty ill over the last year and so on, you know, when you know that there's something out there that is actually, the wheel is running anyway, whether you're around or not, and You Raise Me Up is kind of going to be the sort of legacy after us. And it's given people a lot of comfort and hope, and particularly during this COVID. So I'm so grateful. And the thing about You Raise Me Up is I still remember the very first the intro on our version when we recorded it in 2002. I was very, very tired. We had been working, probably done 14, 15 hours of studio with that, and we decided just to throw in this last little instrumental. Written, and it was a real kind of, like I said, it was like a real Irish air. And I was so tired, I said, you know what, I cannot even stand and play. I actually knelt on the floor and I was like almost in a lotus position, and I played the opening and just tried. And that is still the opening. Our engineer actually captured it, And that's the opening that's in our recording, and it's in the version that you hear on Nocturne now, on the new album, with Brian Kennedy singing it. We've always kept that intro because it was, for us, it was like the really beginning of a story of me, in a way, discovering what this is. Because your role when you're performing music, and mine, Mairead, is that when we're doing something without words, we're telling a story. So. Yeah. Really, I'm telling the first part of the story, which you raised me up. And I still to this day remember so clearly that, you know, dirty, smoke smelly carpet in the studio, Nora, and just sitting there and just, God, there was something about this, you know. And then it just, over the next week, we developed it, and we actually recorded the orchestra on it, and we felt it was complete. And then we thought, no, maybe we should put lyrics to it. And that's when we asked Brendan Graham to write the lyrics. So, yeah, it's been another kind of journey with that song.
I mean, people don't even realize, it's so funny that you said you feel you're playing a cover of your own song, because people don't, I don't think they actually realize that it was Secret Garden and you and Rolf. Yeah. Who wrote that song, Brendan's lyrics? They don't realize. They think it's Josh Groban, or they covered it. And
Josh had the huge hit with it, and a beautiful version, and of course with Dave Foster producing. Wow, you can't get a better, you know. And then, you know, Westlife over here, and I mean the list is. But like, yeah, and you know what? It's been really fun for us to hear all the different versions as well. Yeah. It's a nice thing, but I have to say, I love when, you know, Brian Kennedy here in Ireland. Oh my God. And
so amazing.
Yeah. And he's another cancer survivor. He's incredible. He's, you know, he had cancer the previous year to me. So he's been a guiding force for me as well this year, and, you know, telling me what to expect and whatever. So, but when we record and play it together, it always gives me goosebumps. It's something special.
Well, I mean, Secret Garden songs have been sung by stars all over the world, from Barbara Streisand to Josh Groban to, I mean, you're absolutely huge, and I really appreciate you being here today. And I know your dinner is on the oven.
It's the dinner room. But you know what, Mairead? Seriously, you're so good at this. I mean, apart from being a phenomenal musician, the amount, it just pours out of you. It pours out of every pore of you. It pours out of your family. And I mean, the work you're doing, and you're creating a whole new thing. I mean, you touched on earlier that it is hard being a musician. And for everybody now, and really musicians have lost a whole lifeline. I mean, touring is gone, live concerts are gone. And this is our way of connecting with people and begging you and hoping and praying that you stay with Mairead, stay listening, stay tuning in, and keep the support. Because really, if we don't get support during this whole period, it's not like it's a retail shop that we can, you know, can open up the doors again. And I think all artists really need everybody's support, and especially you.
Oh, well,
I just wish I lived in Dublin and not Boston. I hate that you live there.
I know. What people don't, I suppose, realise is that we don't get to see each other as much as we want, and especially now, you know. And I always say to people, sure, every penny I have is spent on flights home. So, hint, hint, Aer Lingus.
Can't send her Lingus, please bring her home.
But I you know, we have a beautiful performance by you and Rolf from the Eurovision sessions, and I'm going to play it now just to play you out. But I really, really want to thank you so very much from the bottom of my heart for being here and for being so inspiring to people. And I'm just honored to have you, you world famous violinist, on my Facebook. So
thank you to all your fans and supporters, because it's just lovely, really lovely to be here and to be part of your world now, Mairead. And great. Well done.
Well, thank you. Thanks, love. And I'm just going to put this on here, and it's stunning. This is a beautiful acoustic version. Like, it's beautiful version.
We did this from home. Rolf was in his home in Oslo, I think, and I'm here in Dublin. You know, I probably had to take to the bed for another day after this, but anyway, we did this the other day.
Morning, and I'll ring you after, but thank you so much. I'm very conscious of the dinner, and and I love you so much.
Love you too.
And I miss you so much, and can't wait to play a tune with you soon and give you a big hug.
All right, Pat. See ya. Bye.
Love you, hon.
Bye, take care.
Bye, lovey.
Bye. See ya. Bye.
Hi, everybody. Wasn't that just beautiful? And I think it's just such a beautiful way to end today's live broadcast. Thank you so very much to Fionnuala Sherry and Rob Loveland of Secret Garden for that stunning, stunning performance. And make sure and download and get their new album, Nocturne, the 25th Anniversary Collection. And I'll see you next Monday, guys, with another guest. Thank you so much, Fionnuala. Love you so much. Mwah. Bye, everybody. Love you all.